Attention.
Welcome to Modcast Episode 2. Right now, I'm playing Paper Mache Sonic, as Corson likes to call it. It's actually not called that, but, you know, whatever. Anyways, today we've got LuigiChannel here.
Yo.
And we've got Mafdominus here.
Green-nippled cow.
What the? Okay, we're off to a great start. I don't know, I found it funny. I mean, funny because of how random it, whatever. Anyways, shut up. Anyways, so this is Modcast Episode 2. Actually, a lot of people liked Episode 1, so I'm proud of that. I guess let's just get started. Our first topic, and most of these were selected by Corson, again, because of course. And, first topic, PlayStation 5 versus the Xbox Series X. Do you know much about either of these? Because I sure don't.
No, not really.
I mostly know about the PlayStation 5, but honestly, the Xbox Series, I thought it was just another model for the Xbox One.
See, that's what I kind of thought. All I know about it is that it is, apparently it looks like a fridge or something, like a small fridge. Yeah. So we've got, you know, PS5 looks rather sleek from what I can tell. I don't like the disc version that has, like, this weird bit jutting out. Like, they're almost encouraging you to get the discless one, even though that comes with its own set of problems. But
I prefer physical games.
I mean, so do I, kind of. But, no, the big deal with it is just, it looks so much better than the Xbox Series X, which is, like, you know, a brick. Not even a brick, that's not fair to bricks, it's a refrigerator. It's kind of funny, though. But who made that design decision? Go like, yeah, okay, what we need is a refrigerator.
Fabulous idea.
10 out of 10. But yeah, so, I don't know what else to say about it. It's a thing.
All we know is that it's making the same mistake as the Wii U.
What's that?
Alright, so you know how everyone thought the Wii U was basically just an add-on to the Wii?
Yes.
Yeah, everyone thinks the Series X is like an add-on to the Xbox One.
Yeah, or just another model for the Xbox
One. I mean, that's kind of what I thought until, you know, people said, nope, it's a new thing. I'm like, really? I mean, okay. At least with PS5, you know exactly what you're getting into. And say what you want about Sony's recent decisions. At the very least, they're, like, keeping it consistent with, PlayStation 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. They don't have, like, PlayStation X or anything weird like that. And I hope that once we get to the PlayStation 9, they don't just skip it and say, nah, screw it. We're skipping to 10 because it sounds cooler. You know exactly who I'm talking about. But anyways, yeah. So that's the PlayStation 5 and the Xbox Series X. We really don't have much to say about it. Alright. No, go ahead.
What?
Never mind, I guess.
Okay.
Darn it. Anyways, so next we've got what you guys think is the best console ever, since we were talking about consoles. That was a terrible segue. Flug would be very disappointed in me, but whatever. Anyways,
speaking of consoles,
oh my god, no, it's too late now. Whatever.
No, it is never too late. Never say never.
Never. Okay. And yeah. But seriously though, speaking of thing, what do you guys think is the best console ever, in your opinion?
I mean, I don't know. I'm stuck between PlayStation 3 and Xbox 360. Those are the ones I grew up with, and you know, I can't decide.
I grew up with a PS3 too, PS2 and PS3.
I only had a so PlayStation. I've only had a PlayStation 2. I've also only I had a Wii and a GameCube, but I talked about that kind of last episode. Actually, speaking of which of you two owns a Wii? I assume both of you.
Oh, me.
Yeah, I used to own a Wii, but I gave it away years ago.
Fool! Okay. I mean, whatever. Did you mod it?
No.
Did you, Math?
I mean, I pretty much did the opposite of mod and kind of broke it.
How'd you break it?
It wasn't my fault. I was trying to get...
It wasn't my fault!
I was trying to get the little scanner thing to, you know, align with my Wii remote, and then it just fell.
Oh, wow. Wait, the what to align?
The sensor bar?
I don't know what you call it. You know how
the sensor bar?
The control. Yeah, the sensor bar.
It fell? And?
It fell. It was on top of the shelf. That's right.
And?
The only thing that broke?
That should
still work, but, you know, now there's a dent on it.
So? If it still works, there's a dent on it. Like, does that mean part of it just doesn't work? Or, like, it still works, it just doesn't look nice?
It doesn't look nice.
So?
Oh, wow. It's not broken.
I broke it! Well, okay, actually, I did break it. It was just got dented. It's like, oh, alright.
Everything is broken now, so.
Great. So, I guess I'm the only one here who modded my Wii, which, you know, I thought it was great.
Is it scientific?
I don't know. I can play a lot of consoles on there now. If I want to.
Disappoint me. Science is supposed to march on and you disappoint.
Anyways. But this is about the best console ever. I don't think the Wii is the... Actually, it's not the best console ever, but it's kind of close. Then again, I only play, like, on the PC now. So,
same here for the most part, unless I'm like live stream.
For the most part, unless it's like first of all, it has to be an exclusive. Second of all, it has to be an exclusive for a console I own. Then, you know, then I'll play like, you know, like Smash Ultimate is obviously a Switch exclusive and whatever, but
yeah.
Now, I don't know. I play most stuff on PC now. That's what we just said, but I do use I did use the Wii for GameCube backwards compatibility, so yeah, you had all the GameCube games, and what was that?
I burped.
Okay. Yeah, you had like all of the Wii games and all the GameCube games, so I'd say that's a win in my book. And honestly,
that's my answer, honestly, for the best console.
Yeah, actually thinking about it, you know, given how many great Wii games and GameCube games you could play, I mean, now granted, there is one problem. It didn't have, like, you know, it had the Wii Shop, which is unfortunately closed now. But it didn't have too much in the way of backwards compatibility. I mean, it's better than certain other consoles that might or might not be out right now. But, you know, I wanted to play a bunch of games on there. Of course, unintentionally, it was enabled by, like, homebrew and stuff, where like most of, especially the old Nintendo consoles, like you can play those like flawlessly on the Wii with homebrew software. And yes, before someone says it, emulators are legal. The ROMs are yeah, anyways.
I mean, I never even realized some people called them illegal. I mean,
well a lot of people,
I mean, I always knew the ROMs were.
Well, I mean, the ROMs are illegal.
Yeah.
Yeah. But yeah, emulators are legal.
I mean, I have a PSP emulator, so I can play all the PSP. I don't know what a PSP is.
No, I know what a PSP is. Like, how many people, like, played that? Like, I'm sure plenty, but, like, you know, I thought it was, like, really overshadowed by the DS.
Yeah, the DS is the more popular cousin.
Yeah.
Alright.
But the PSP is nice, so, you know, it's got good games on there.
So, have you come to a conclusion, Math, on what you would say is the best console?
I guess I could say the PlayStation 3, mainly because, you know, it's a childhood relic. I used to have it, but my dad gave it away. It's a great childhood relic. I used to play Uncharted, Drake's Fortune all the time. And the Monster vs. Aliens, the video game, and Lego Indiana Jones, and all
that. Hey, my first game for my PS3 was Ice Age 3.
Oof.
I guess since we're talking about first PlayStation games, my first, like, PlayStation 2 game was Gran Turismo. So, if that means anything to anyone. Did any of you guys play that?
No.
Aww. Okay. I don't know. I find it fun.
The only reason I even got the Xbox 360 was to basically play Minecraft on it. Because, you know, I didn't know how a PC worked.
Yes, because God forbid you play it on a PC.
Yes, because yeah. That's what God told me.
But, yeah. Yeah. Anyways, I don't know, I guess let's just go on to the next topic since I don't have anything else to add. Alright, just ruin, I was going to say just ruin my thing to the next topic, but then I realized I don't have any sort of, like, transition to the next topic. So yeah, YouTube.
Yay.
It's
weird.
I don't know. I think a lot of people like to say 2016 YouTube was better. That's debatable.
I like 2016.
I think in terms of, like, you know, oh, you don't get demonetized for every little thing. Yeah, it was better. But in terms of, like, you know, actually, being a better just place to see things? I don't know. Actually, no, it probably was, but, you know, I don't think it's peak YouTube, if that makes any sense.
Yeah, I don't agree with that.
I don't think that 2016 YouTube was peak YouTube.
No.
Actually, depending on who you ask it, I would understand if someone said it, though. Like, you know, it's certainly way better than it is now. I mean, yeah, you know, no one liked Leafy and whatever, but great. But
that was my first year.
Why
would
you remind me of Leafy? Oh God, I used to unironically watch him.
Yo, yeah, I used to watch him a lot.
Great.
I'm embarrassed. I am embarrassed by the fact that I used to watch him. It's just.
But yeah, so, you know, you can have the whole, oh, he mean and whatever, but at the same time, it's kind of one of these deals where it's like, so instead of having Leafy, we've instead traded in Leafy for, like, super ultra sanitized, like, you know, Oh, I can't say that word, kids. It might get me demonetized. Ugh. It's like,
the cough cough?
Well, oh, the cough cough, which we will talk about later.
Oh, yeah. I think the cough cough is a...
Oh, no! He has the cough! He must...
Wait, no.
He must be destroyed!
I just coughed, I swear!
Liar, that's what they all say!
Or I'm probably not a goofy goober.
Rock. Anyways, okay, quick question for everyone. What is peak website design for YouTube? Like, what's the peak layout for YouTube? I hate the current one.
2011.
I used to hate the current one. I've kind of gotten used to it now.
I've been avoiding the current one for like 3 years. Like, I keep finding workarounds to make sure I do not get switched to it.
Yeah, I was about to ask that because I found workarounds for a while, but then just
I found a workaround and stuff that emulates the 2011 style. So I'm basically back in 2011. Kinda.
I don't think I ever saw that layout, to be honest.
I like the 2011 layout. That's the one I'm most nostalgic for.
I think the only one. Used to the new one. I think the one I really like, which is kind of strange since a lot of people didn't like it back in the day, but I really liked kind of the 2011. Like, it's called the Cosmic Panda layout. If that makes any sense. I really like the channel designs especially. And, I don't know, you'll have to look up screenshots of it if you don't know what I'm talking about.
Oh, yeah, I have seen that.
Yeah. I don't know, I really liked it, but it's probably also because it was the first one I really fully remember. Like, it wasn't the first one that I used, but it was the first one I really remembered using a lot. And then everything changed when YouTube decided, nah, screw you. You get terrible layout now. But, oh my goodness, I don't know. It's just a bit disappointing. What?
What?
What'd he say? Of course.
Understood all of that.
With a Q.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Well, thank you for understanding.
Yeah. No, I totally get it. Crap. Anyways, I don't know. I think YouTube is a bit... We've gone from, like, way too edgy to way too sanitized, and it's... I don't like it. Like, you know, I think the, and I could be wrong, but I think the whole edgy YouTube whatever phase of, like, 2016 would have died down on its own, but instead YouTube kind of forced it. And so now everything feels kind of, like, stilted, I guess. It's kind of, I mean, not everything feels fake, obviously. There are still plenty of people who try to get away with things, and it works enough for them. But, you know, we've got people going like, oh, sorry, can't say that word. YouTube might be listening. It's like really creepy and I don't like it.
I don't either.
But, yeah. Then again, for all I know, I'll have to cut out this whole segment. Woo! Anyways.
If it does cut out this part of the video, let me explain what happened. Basically, cough, cough. And YouTube, and that's what happened. Now you're caught up. Did I get it right?
Yeah, no, you got it right. 100%.
Yay!
Yay! Alright, let's move on to Minecraft.
Minecraft!
This reminds... Oh, wait, actually, no. This whole section reminds me of the famous YouTube video, Inspector Gadget Plays Minecraft, where he says, it is too late to build brown bricks with Minecraft.
Sometimes you got to say never. It is too late.
Sometimes you got to say never. All right, anyways, yeah. So, Minecraft. I heard the Nether update is coming out, I think, tomorrow?
Really?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Which kind of sucks, because it's also the same day that Battle for Bikini Bottom Rehydrated is coming out, and I can only pick one to stream. So, you know.
Wow.
Rip.
Oof. So, anybody got a juicy Minecraft story?
Oh, yes, I remember my favorite mod where it creates a girlfriend for you and then you throw a piece of bread at it and then you say, now you can go make me a sandwich. do you remember that? Did you guys ever watch that video?
All I know is that there was a lot of sex Minecraft videos.
Oh, yeah.
I was very curious about this, you know, as a kid.
That was a different time.
The good old days, back when there was no such thing as fucking pull-up.
What?
What?
When there was no such thing as what?
Fucking polar bears.
What?
What?
There are polar
bears. Oh, yeah, the Minecraft polar bears. Yeah, no, I remember that.
Yeah, it pisses me off. Why do we need polar bears in Minecraft? If I wanted polar bears, I'd get the Mo Creatures mod or whatever. But, you know, I just... No. No, we don't need polar bears in Minecraft. That was a big mistake.
I feel like the later Minecraft updates are just kind of adding more stuff that mods have already...
I mean, I think the Nether update will be good, but the other ones... 1.15. Hey, look, guys, we had funny B. It's like, all right, what else did you add?
Nothing.
We had bees. So Minecraft, yeah, it's a game.
It's a game. Good old childhood.
I don't know how often people play it.
I haven't stopped playing it since I first got it.
Math.
Sometimes play it.
You have it on PC, right, Math? You didn't just stick with the Xbox version?
Oh, no. I moved on to the Nintendo Switch version, so...
Ew!
Oh, wow.
To be fair...
Ew!
My PC's, it's not good right now, so, you know, I might just move on to my laptop or something.
Okay.
I repeat my previous sentiments of... Ew!
Poor!
No. Leave.
Yes.
Leave.
Yes!
Leave! No! What was that? Anyways.
That was the noise I made.
Obviously. Anyways.
Yeah.
I don't have a good segue for this.
Neither do I.
Hold on. Let me try to come up with a segue for this. Let's see. Next topic is... so you know there's this Minecraft mod that used to have Sonic stuff in it? And, Oh, yeah, speaking of Sonic...
I was going to do that. So, I guess that works. Anyway, so yeah, Sonic, I'm actually playing a Sonic game kind of right now, except it isn't...
Is it a good Sonic game?
I mean, yes, the only problem is that some of the best Sonic games are fan games!
Legit.
Like,
for years, I absolutely hated Sonic, okay? Alright? For years, I did not like that little blue fuck, alright?
Wow, okay.
It all started back in the PlayStation 3 days. I was just having fun with my PlayStation 3, but then I decided I wanted to get a new game.
And then Sonic.exe jumped out of the screen. I'm sorry, go ahead.
I wish, but, you know, it's just that then I unfortunately saw the Sonic 06 on PlayStation
2. Oh my god.
So,
of course.
Yeah, that was my first Sonic game, Sonic 06.
Ha!
Can you honestly blame me?
No, I
took Sonic for years. You know, eventually I stopped hating him and, you know, realized some of the games are good, but, you know, it's just for years, Sonic 06 just, ugh, it pissed me off, ruined my childhood and stuff.
Yeah, well, I mean, yeah, but I still don't get, and I know I've told people about this before, but the best Sonic games, it seems now, are fan games. Like, this one I'm playing right now, say what you want about it. Corson likes to call it Paper Mache Sonic, because it runs in the Doom Engine, but,
well, I thought it was called that because it was like Paper Mario.
No. There's no Paper Sonic. But I actually really like this game. It's actually...
Me too, I love Robo Blast.
Yeah, it's actually fun. I will, in fact, you know what, I'll even leave a link to it in the description for anyone who wants to play it. Until, of course, I forget after editing this to put it in the description, but anyways, someone will remind me, I'm sure. But, yeah, so no, it's one of these deals where, oh, okay. But yeah, I don't get why fans make the best Sonic games. Like, you know, you could say, oh, Sonic Mania, but Sonic Mania was basically a fan game that, Sega slapped their logo on.
Pretty much.
And that's, like, the extent of it.
Sonic Mania's a bit meh.
Get out. I'm joking. But yeah, and then you've got, like, then it's like, alright, Sega, we had Sonic Forces, even though it was basically a fan game, what's next? So you got...
Sonic the Hedgehog movie.
So, actually, I did not watch Sonic the Hedgehog movie, as I mentioned.
I watched it recently.
Get out!
No.
I'm just kidding.
But, yeah, no, it's... So it's like, okay, what's next after Sonic Mania? We got Sonic Forces.
Mm,
yeah, great, yes. Great.
Sonic Forces, yeah, okay, it's bad, it's bad.
Like, oh, it was so disappointing. And it's not even like, you know, Sonic 06 bad. I know you don't like Sonic 06 map, and I don't think anyone does, but you know... Sonic 06 is kind of good for, like, the glitches and stuff, and is so bad it's good type of deal.
I'm not gonna say anything.
Why?
He's shy.
No reason.
No, why?
He's shy.
Go ahead. Say your bit.
Alright, I have a lot of nostalgia for 06, mainly for the cutscenes. I mean, I only got the game just to see how bad it was, and I came out with the impression that it wasn't as bad, but it still wasn't good.
Great.
So there.
But yeah, no, I think the game is bad. I think most people think the game is bad, except Luigi, because why not? But I don't know. To me, it's a so bad, it's kind of good game. Like, so many glitches you can exploit. I love that type of thing. But, yeah, no, as it stands, though... And then you've just got... I don't know, just... I can't believe... Like, what? Why can't Sega make a good Sonic thing?
They don't want to.
Guess.
Pretty much. I mean, what? Forces had, like, three level designers entirely. And two of them were from Lost World.
Ew.
Jurassic Park.
I knew you would make a joke about Jurassic Park eventually.
What? No. Nah, definitely. It's not like I have a Jurassic Park profile picture or anything and I'm a huge fan of the movie. No, yeah, you know. Yeah, no one would ever expect I would make a Jurassic Park joke.
Alright. What? What on earth? Okay.
I have an instrument with me just in case we needed original music.
Great. So I'm really impressed with, you know, Sonic fan stuff, you know, for the most part. But I'm also really disappointed by, like, Sega. Like, you know, what would you say is the last, you know, definitively good Sonic game? Like, probably Generations?
I mean, I haven't played that many Sonic
games. I mean, no one's going to disagree with me on this, but I like Lost World.
Jurassic Park.
Ew! Yeah, no, I didn't. No. Nuh-uh. I don't like, I mean, Lost World is kinda alright. Like, you know those underwater, rail sections?
Yeah.
I really like those. But, like, that's the extent of how much I enjoy Lost World. And that's mainly for the music. The level is kind of secondary, honestly. But, yeah, then the rest of it is just kind of... Okay.
I mean, I'd say it's better than Forces.
That's not a competition!
Yeah, I know.
That's like winning a competition against a person who didn't even show up.
Oh, you want to hear competition, eh? Well, you know, it's not like you get broken up with your girlfriend and she leaves you for a black guy title. What? Really? What? It was black!
My goodness.
Lily, I missed you!
Dear God!
I miss Lily!
Who is Lily?! he reminded me of that one character from SpongeBob, like the Ripped Pants episode where he's like, why? Why? Everything has to be a SpongeBob reference with me. Everything.
I don't blame you. SpongeBob's pretty good, you know, show.
But, yeah, so... that was great. Anyways, what were we talking about?
That fucking whore, Lily.
No! What were we actually talking about?
I think Sonic.
Yes,
Sonic. All right. You mentioned Sonic Forces and whatever. But, yeah, no. Sonic Forces is not good. Neither is Lost World, in my opinion, barring a couple exceptions. But, so, last definitively good game, I'd say, was Generations. And then before that was... I thought Colors was decent, but I think it gets way too much, oh man, this is a good game. No, like, Act 1 of every single world is great. And then the rest is kind of like, well, it exists. Didn't say it was good.
Much. A lot of the game is just 2D block sections.
Yeah, and I don't like that bit.
Neither do I.
But, great. Anyways, yeah, so that's Sonic. It's
Sonic the Hedge.
Yes, Sonic the Hedge.
You know, it was one of it was like one of the last movies I saw before, you know, theaters were shut down.
Yeah. You've heard of Over the Hedge, now get ready for Sonic the Hedge. And speaking of theaters, let's talk about the theaters.
What do you mean, speaking of theaters? I just made a good transition right there.
Shut up.
I just made a good transition
right there.
Sonic the Hedgehog. It was like the last movie I saw before the theaters were shut down. God damn you, WH dude. Why you betray me like this?
Because
like that bitch Lily.
Anyways. Yeah, no, seriously though. So a bunch of theaters are closed due to the cough, and Math wanted a topic revolving around what will happen once they reopen. Like, will there be... Actually, okay. Like, real talk for a minute here. I genuinely think this might be the, like, you know, theaters were already kind of on the decline with the whole streaming thing and whatever. But now, like, you know, now that people have kind of gotten used to, like, you know, not going to the theaters, something tells me that this will be the, maybe not the end, but certainly it will have really accelerated the end of theaters, like normal theaters. I don't know. But, you know, I'm not complaining about it. I think movie theaters kind of suck.
You dare say that I'm gonna
fuck! What was that noise? Did Donald Duck just speak through math?
No, you fucking idiot! This is Mickey Mouse!
Great!
So anyways, you better go into theaters now, bitches! Otherwise, we'll lose a lot of money, and we're gonna shut down Disney World forever! So you better go back in the fucking movie theaters, or so help me!
That's great! Anyways,
I hope the movie theaters reopen, because I love going to the theaters, alright?
Why?
It's an experience that streaming can't give you. See, I get it. I get it. Streaming is good because you get to stay at home and cook up a hot pocket and, you know, the heater's on and, you know, stuff like that. But there's just something special about seeing a movie, like, on the big screen, all right? There's just something special about it that you can't get.
Yeah, or maybe I just don't like having to interact with people. You ever think of that?
No.
Just no.
But still.
But okay,
like movie theaters, all right? I like them.
You're allowed to like them. You're allowed to like them. I just don't.
No, I am not. I'm disgusting.
Great. Yeah, I don't know. Just movie theaters kind of freak me out.
Because they're in public, aren't they?
Well, it's not even just that. Like, some of them are kind of, you know, I don't know. Anyways.
I remember you made a comment on one of my videos that you said something that, like, I had more balls or something.
What?
What?
I don't know.
Well, okay, maybe not that specifically, but I think it was, like, in the Hellboy movie review where I, like, screamed like a lunatic in the theater.
Oh yeah, well I hate it when people do that.
Hey, I did it for the video.
For the video. I did it for the video. I did it for the video. I don't think I've ever been a fan, nor will I ever be a fan of movie theaters. And, you know,
I think me and Wstude will be enemies.
Wow, okay.
We're enemies. You are my arch nemesis.
Great. Alright, seriously though?
Arch nemesis, Wstude. He's making this podcast thing. I sabotage it by being in it. Ha ha ha.
Alright, but seriously though, I guess, LuigiChannel, what do you think of movie theaters? And will you be upset if they go away?
Honestly, no, I haven't been the one in quite a long time.
I just hear Math slowly getting angrier and angrier. Yeah, I don't know. Just one of
hopefully
these.
They reopen.
I mean, I think they'll reopen. I just don't think attendance will be nearly as high. Especially since, you know, I think one of the big movies that, you know, everyone was, you know, really, like, that's what really drove people to the theaters. That being, Infinity War and Endgame. I mean, now that that's over.
Oh, yeah, good movie.
But now that that's over, I don't think that, you know, and this is more a Marvel thing than it is, like, a theater thing, but I don't think it will ever kind of be the same. But hey,
unless Black Widow does numbers, you know.
Anyways,
wait, are you making a Nah,
what are you talking about, man? Anyways, seriously though, like, I don't know. I don't think things will really ever reach their peak again, especially not after the cough and all. But hey, there is one thing that could be said. At the very least, Endgame got a larger box office than Avatar, which, thank God.
Why?
Because Avatar, from what I've been told, is like super overrated.
It's not that overrated. I mean, it's a pretty good movie. It's just, I mean, to be fair, I understand, you know, Avatar, it definitely doesn't deserve to be like the highest grossing film, but
well, I think it was one of these, at least this is what Zeke told me. But he said it was one of those movies that, like, you know, people watched it for the like the CG and all, and it was, yeah, you know, revolutionary for the time, and that's great. But then it's like, okay, so what's the movie about and whatever? Oh, well, it's about the blue people. Okay, cool. What else? And like, no one cared about the movie. They just cared about the actual plot or whatever. They just cared about, oh, look, it's blue people.
You're going to be excited, but there's going to be an Avatar 2 coming out, so.
No. Shut up. No.
Yeah.
I don't believe you.
Avatar 2 becomes the highest grossing film, and it beats Avengers Endgame.
It's
a possibility.
No. I mean. No. Stop.
Yes.
Stop. Yes. No. I don't want that.
Right now.
I don't want that.
Avatar 2. If Avatar 2 becomes the highest grossing film and managed to beat Avengers Endgame, you know what? I called it. I'm from the future.
No. I don't.
Here we are in the future.
No. Why?
It seemed appropriate.
Yeah, no, that was definitely what I was thinking. I don't know. I will be very disappointed.
Sure you will.
I actually will.
Sure you will.
What's this voice you're doing? Yeah, you will. It's like,
I don't know. I was trying to sound like Mr. Krabs in like that one episode of SpongeBob where
you could do a
destroys Plankton's livelihood and what?
So you could do a great. So you could do a perfectly good like Mickey Mouse impression, yet God forbid you do a even halfway decent Mr. Krabs.
I can also do a Carl Weezer if you want.
I want to hear this.
Are you going to finish that croissant?
Yeah, not as good.
Yay!
I said not as good.
Not as... I'm going to throw my Bionicles across the room.
Great.
Perfect. Anyways, yeah, no, I don't know. Do you have anything else you want to say about the cough and the theaters reopening?
Isn't it a little weird that they're re-releasing old movies on the theaters just to get people's butts in them?
I don't know.
I mean, Back to the Future is now in theaters again for some reason.
Wait, is it now?
Yeah, I mean, it's a good movie, but I don't know. It just seems kind of dumb re-releasing movies.
I mean, it is kind of dumb. But, you know, whatever.
I can just watch them. Like, I'll admit, I don't want to pay really expensive money just to watch a movie that I have already on Netflix.
Arg. I mean, what?
Arrgh.
Anyway, seriously though, I don't know. I think the theaters
said that like three times.
Shut up. I think the theaters are actually trying to hang on for dear life. It's like, okay, guys, what do we got? Well, we had Infinity War and Endgame. Okay, good, good, good. Okay, what else have we got?
Jurassic Park.
Okay, okay, also good, also good. What else? What else will get people in here? Crap.
Christopher Nolan movie.
To be fair, take all of this with a grain of salt, since I don't, like, really watch movies at all.
I don't either.
You motherfucker!
If you had watched episode one, you would have known this.
Well, I only stopped halfway through, so...
Why? Were we not entertaining enough for you?
Because I fell asleep.
Why'd you fall asleep? Were we not entertaining enough for you?
It was midnight and I was tired.
I don't care what you think.
Oh, okay.
Watch the podcast and no one gets hurt, kid.
Okay.
That's what I thought. Anyways, I don't know what else to talk about. So, we've got the extra category.
I think that's just, like, cherry-picking stuff.
I don't know. What do you guys want to talk about? We're not even at, like, an hour.
I turn this into an hour.
Quick, we gotta stretch this out to an hour!
My favorite color is blue, favorite food is a pizza. My favorite.
Hold on. What's your favorite vegetable, huh?
My favorite vegetable. My previous girlfriend. She was like on a wheelchair.
Oh my god! Stop!
Why? You told me what was my favorite vegetable. I mean, I only had like one vegetable. So, I don't know. It's like the only experience I had with a vegetable.
What's your favorite vegetable, girlfriend? It's like, okay.
She's on a wheelchair, dude. Have some
Stop. Whatever. Anyways, yeah, no. Who said that? Did you say that? Map, why did you say that?
I don't know. I thought it was appropriate because wheelchairs.
Okay.
And that bitch Lily.
Oh my goodness.
I want her on a wheelchair now.
Wow. Okay. Anyways. So
do we talk about our favorite fruits now? I mean, you talked about vegetables.
I'm afraid of you talking about your favorite fruits because something tells me it will become awful.
Well, is there something awful about liking apples?
I mean, I guess not.
Exactly, man. Why you always gotta assume that apples are terrible? Apple lives matter, man.
No, I was just thinking you would do something else.
Hmm.
Oh, no.
I got nothing.
Good. You should have nothing.
So anyways, the next thing we have is...
Nothing.
Extra.
We're already on extra!
Okay, so after my favorite movie, Pan's Labyrinth, my favorite video game would have to be, actually, that's actually kind of a tough choice. My favorite video game is, I like a lot of games, but I don't think I have a favorite. I don't know. And anyways, my favorite toy would be Bionicle. The favorite toy company will be from NECA. They make some high-quality toys. Fuck!
Calm down! Calm down, man!
You sounded like that one guy on the internet who said, "It's just a game. Why you gotta be so upset? It's just a game, man.
It's just a game, man.
Just a game." Oh yeah, my favorite meme will... Actually, if I say any memes, it'll just be dead by the time this video gets uploaded.
Hey, people will watch this in like a month and go like, ew.
What's the current popular meme right now?
I don't know.
I have no clue.
Phew, this video won't be dated then.
LuigiChannel, do you have anything to talk about?
I mean, there is something we could talk about, but I don't really want to.
How's your sex life?
Non-existent.
Okay.
I don't know.
Anyway.
I'm just remembering. How's your sex life? Non-existent.
Just caught that.
No, I got that, but like, you know, I'm remembering it. Anyways. Yeah. You guys have anything else you want to... Oh, why am I doing so terribly at this? Anything else you guys want to talk about?
Well, anyway, let's talk about our today's sponsor, Raid Shadow.
No!
Raid Shadow Legends. It's one of the best mobile games and most
delicious
mobile game ever made.
You! No!
You should download it.
No!
A free gold.
Actually, okay. Shut up.
Mafdominus Rock.
Shut up. No, stop. I have an actual question about Raid since I'm thinking about it. Have either of you two played it, and is it actually any good?
I have never played it.
Matthew.
I haven't.
Matthew, disappoint me. You seem like the type of person to play that.
Wait. The type?
The type! The voice crack.
Excuse me, I may be a mobile master race, but I do not play degenerate crap like Raid Shadow Legends. I play Jurassic World the game.
Also, mobile master race, that's a first, I'll admit.
I've never heard that before.
Mobile is the best.
Fuck PC! Can you put the PC in your pocket? No, you can't.
Who actually thinks mobile is the best? Like, unironically, who?
I was just joking. Nah.
Oh.
Mobile. The problem with mobile games is that there's barely any good mobile games. It's mainly just pay-to-win stuff. That's pretty much it. It's just pay-to-win. Like, oh, you want to advance to this level? You gotta pay 25 gems to proceed. That's a, like,
I hate that. I like Angry Birds.
Oh, Angry Birds is good, until it's got pay to win shit in. No joke, I literally thought that was the actual sound effect from Angry Birds. No joke. I legitimately thought, like, did you get fucking red in here or something?
Yeah, no, I got red in here.
Oh, is there? Hey, Red, fuck you!
That means that the Angry Birds sound effects are pretty much just some guy screaming. Cause that's what I did. I just started yelling. I don't know.
Anyways, how about a music solo? I thought that was a woman for a second there.
What?
Like, yes. You said, yes, all yes. Like a... Yes, all the women in this group. Mm-hmm. Yep.
We don't have that much interactions with girls, don't we?
No.
Why would we?
Yeah, we're the losers club. Except for me, because, you know, everybody loves me. Nobody likes you guys.
Wow.
Oh,
jerk.
Wow.
Yeah. That kid on Fortnite, he's calling me a dickhead again.
Oh, no.
Yeah, new Master 69. This little piece of shit just called me a dickhead again.
You better go take care of that.
Yeah, I think I will. You know, I think I'll take care of all of them. Yeah, I'm gonna show up to school tomorrow and take care of all of them.
Oh, no. Oh, no. We better end this episode before... Ooh.
Yeah.
Thank you all for watching Modcast.
That bitch Lily will get what she fucking
deserves. Oh, no. Featuring LuigiChannel and Math. I'm gonna...
Green nipples!
I'm gonna end it now. Bye. Bye.
The wheel spins! Spin wheel! Spin! Thank you.